In 1957, thalidomide, a new wonder drug, was introduced in Europe. It provided relief to grateful expectant mothers suffering from morning sickness. Sadly, the medication was causing many thousands of children across the globe to be born with severe deformities. We do not know for certain how thalidomide caused birth defects. It may have shut down blood vessels in growing babies, causing abnormal development of organs. The tragedy of thalidomide babies was largely prevented in the United States by a new medical reviewer at the FDA named Dr. Francis Oldham Kelsey. In 1960, Dr. Kelsey, a pharmacologist and physician, had only been at the FDA for a month when the application to sell thalidomide under the brand name Kevadon came across her desk. She felt the drug company's evidence was lacking and insisted on having the scientific proof that thalidomide was safe before the application could be approved. Over the next year, the drug company often complained to her superiors, yet the FDA stood by her decision. Toward the end of 1961, researchers in Germany and Australia were beginning to link thalidomide to the sharp rise in certain types of birth defects, and countries feverishly pulled it from the marketplace. Dr. Francis Oldham Kelsey was hailed as an American hero. A grateful President John F. Kennedy presented her with the Distinguished Civilian Service Medal. Because thalidomide was sold in dozens of countries, we will never know the number of babies that were never born because of the drug. What we do know is that countless others were saved by an everyday hero. The worldwide thalidomide tragedy did lead to some positive reforms in the United States. The Kefauver-Harris Amendment to the 1938 Food, Drug, and Cosmetic Act was a direct response to the thalidomide tragedy. The 1962 legislation required that all new drug applications demonstrate substantial evidence of the drug's effectiveness. In other words, the drug had to show that it would do what it was advertised to do, in addition to being safe. The Drug Efficacy and Safety Initiative followed. It mandated that drugs approved between 1938 and 1962 be reviewed to establish that they worked. Drugs that were shown not to work could be removed from the market. In July of 1998, under the absolute strictest safety standards, thalidomide was approved by the FDA to treat a skin problem caused by leprosy. In May 2006, it was approved for the treatment of a type of cancer called multiple myeloma. It's currently one of the most highly regulated drugs in American history.